Well, there we are. We've got a little mock-up right there. The flywheel turns nice and smooth. I'll turn it around. And you can see the eccentric on this side over here working. And the crankshaft right in there. Of course, the piston and connecting rod are not in there right now, nor is the some other pieces that are on there. The part that I'm going to be making today is going to be the valve chest that goes on the side. So let's go ahead and we'll get that started. Okay, here's the part that I'll be machining, is the valve chest. I've got a valve chest cover, and eventually the third part of this right here is this thing that they call the slide valve. Let's take a look and see how all that fits together. This is the valve chest, and what it does, it fits on the side of this cylinder like this. And of course it'll be machined and it'll be matched up where it should be. Now there's a dome on top. This is not drilled through. When it gets ready to go, there's going to be a rod that goes through like this and comes out the bottom. And this rod is going to be driven by the eccentric that's right here. If you notice, that eccentric is turned off center. Well, that's what gives the rotary motion into this linear motion that you have here. Now, what this does, this valve chest, moves the slide valve. The slide valve, if you notice, it's got four pegs on it like this, connected at the bottom. And there's going to be a piece that goes in that's got threads in it that bar goes through. And it does slide back and forth. Now here's what it slides back and forth on. If you notice, you've got three holes. You've got, and this is the inlet hole for that matches up over here for your steam or air inlet. And it's drilled to right here. Now what the slide valve does, it has a little depression in the bottom of it. And when it slides down to here, it's actually routing the air from this one up through the top, down through this way, and out to the hole that's in here that's going to drive the piston. Now, just as soon as it goes up, you're going to see that it also comes up, or rather when it makes the return stroke, this moves up. Now the air or steam would go in here, it's transferred across this little indent right here, and then it goes right out through the steam cavity that's in there. This block is pressurized, and what will happen on it, this is where your exhaust will come out, because as this slides back and forth, one of these is going to be open when your piston goes up. In other words, when your air goes in here, the piston's going to go back up that way. You're going to need to let the pressure off, and that's where your exhaust goes back. So this is a slide valve on the steam engine. That's not heavy-duty machining work right here. It's just a matter of cleaning things up. There's one interesting aspect of this. The bottom part of this, or actually be like that, where your connecting rod goes into the, down to your crankshaft, this is actually offset. This one is going to be slightly offset to one side. It's not quite in the middle as it goes through there. This piece right here is just straightforward. And these make nice little polished embellishments on the steam engine. When you do that, you'll paint it and then put it on some sandpaper, sand it down and polish it up, and it'll really look nice by the time you get through with that. So we're going to get started. I'm going to clean this up right here. This is just a matter of taking some flashing out. This is not a big machining project. I'm not going to show you all the setups on it. It's essentially just a vise. Locate four holes. I'll take those four holes and then I'll transfer those over to the cylinder, drill a hole in the cylinder, and that part right there will be done. And this is just putting the four-jaw chuck in turned. I'll show you a chuck, or I'll show you when I have it chucked up in the lathe in just a moment. So now, I don't know if you can see it or not very well due to the lights and so forth, But I do have my offsets. You can see it offset just a little bit, where this side here is closer to the center than that part right there is. Now, I use an end mill. You can use a fly cutter. I just prefer a half inch end mill for my facing, especially for small jobs like this. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is go in and face off these sides and make sure that they are nice and flat. Now, what I'm doing here is I am getting a reference point. So I'm taking 30 thousandths off of one side, and then I'm going to take it off or turn it over, and I'm going to take 30 thousandths off the other side. So I've got that side smooth, this side smooth. So now these are going to be my two reference points, this side here, that side right there. So now if I come over and I take 30 thousandths off of this side, now I can go back when I get through here and go back and now match it up to my cylinder width. I'll show you that in just a minute. Now I've got one more measurement to make, or one more trim up. Remember, I'm just getting it all four sides. So now I've got one side. Those two are parallel with each other. Now I've got to get the back side done. So bring it back out, and I'll get it jigged up. So what's going on right now, as you can see, I've got it chucked up in the forge jaw, and I've got the offset and everything turned down. So this is just going to be a turning operation. What I'll do is this piece, this little spigot piece right here, will be turned down in dimension. I'll also flatten off this side right here, true it up, and get it a nice flat surface. Then also what will happen is there will be a 1/4 by 28 thread in here, internal thread, and there'll be a, I believe it was 5/32. Anyway, it was the rod, the valve rod. I'll have to make a hole that will go all the way through. But you can just turn the film back a little bit, and it'll show you exactly what those plans were on this. So this straightforward operation, just true it up in the forge jaw chuck and start working on it. So I've got that cleaned up good, and again, one of the things, I'll go back a little bit, when I sprayed that primer on there, the primer is really good not only as a protectant, but it also goes back when you're doing these operations. When you've got your primer off, you know you've got everything nice and square. So the next operation is to go ahead and start drilling through there with a, let me check over here on the plans. Well, it looks like it's a 1/8 diameter, and I'll go ahead and ream that through. Here's where I am right here, 1/8 diameter through, and then that says 1/4 by 32, but it'll be a 1/4 by 28 because I don't have a 1/4 by 32 tap. But the offset and everything is already built into it, and got all that taken care of. And then I'll just go back and I'll do this side actually with the file, the top side, and I'll just round that off really nice with the file, bring the lathe tool in and take care of the top of it. Alrighty, so you'll see me, the next part of it's going to be nothing but just drilling that 1/8 hole, doing the 1/4 by 28 tap for this right here.